Hello, welcome to my channel once again. Today I'm here to show you something, show you a video actually, a video that a lady did on TikTok, and she says something that I think it's very important for all of us to also think about, and also I think I have lots of Africans from the diaspora who watch my channel. I want you guys to tell me what you think about this particular video. You know, one thing that I don't understand is I don't know why people, especially Africans from the diaspora, or Africans that are in the diaspora who have not been to Africa before, have this negative thoughts about Africa, all because of some one or two experiences that some few African Americans or blacks from the diaspora have experienced. I just don't know why. But as I said, we are going to watch the video. So if you haven't subscribed to my channel, please subscribe to my channel, like the video, comment whatever you think, and then after this video, let's talk about it. Let's discuss about this particular video. So let's watch the video.
I am a Black American and I absolutely love to travel to the continent of Africa. It's my favorite continent in the whole wide world. But one of my biggest fears is that the more Black Americans come to this continent, they will not handle it with grace and with care. So, for example, I am in Ghana right now and I'm getting messages and people are sending me texts of people who had a bad experience at a festival, or like all two people who got their phone stolen, and people are like, oh my God, I'm afraid, I can't come, they don't have their stuff together, this is that. And I'm like, that is their experience. It's not my job to negate or validate somebody's personal experience. That is what happened to them. But I just wish more Black Americans handled the systems that they think need to be in place with more care, understanding the historical context for why those conditions actually exist. And also understand that negative news about the continent literally drives people's internalized fear that Africa is inherently bad, and it literally feeds stereotypes. I'm not telling people how they should feel. I'm just saying that as Black Americans, with all your Western ideology and our privilege and our internalized challenges with the continent already, let's make sure we handle it with more care and more grace.
So right now, let me ask, why is it that people think Africa is so dangerous, and you come to a place, you got your phone stolen? Your phone stolen. It's not like your phone stolen and you are speaking as if the whole country is dangerous, it's not a good place to come, or it's not like it's a bad place to be and all that. I just don't understand why some people have this perception about Africa. McMill came to Ghana and his phone was stolen. He came to Ghana and his phone was stolen by a certain guy, and with the help of the police, he was able to get his phone back. These are like people, like petty thieves. They don't even know, because the question is, can you even steal an iPhone? How can you even steal an iPhone? Like, it doesn't even make sense, because you can easily be trapped. How can you steal an iPhone? You understand? So sometimes certain petty things that people steal from you when you come to Africa, and you are using it to judge the whole continent, I just don't get it. Why some of you people do these things? Let me ask a question. Between Africa, or between Ghana and America, or between Ghana or Africa and the UK and Europe, let's be honest, which place is like safer? Which of these places is much more safer? Even with a global peace index that we have, Ghana is the second most peaceful country in the whole of Africa. And even when it comes to globally, Ghana is still ahead of America. the safest country or the most peaceful country. So what are you telling me? I want to get these people that always they try to make people scared, or I don't even know how to even put it. They try to scare them from coming to Africa whilst they have not been to Africa. I just don't understand why. So please, I don't know what you are going to say about this, but if you have anything, and you know something, I have a video that I want to share with you. I've actually shared this video before, but I will put it in this particular video that you are watching right now. And these are some of the experiences of some missionaries, and I'll say Africans who have come into the, or who came to the, like to the continent, especially Ghana, who came to Ghana, and they were sharing their experiences. I just want you to take a look at this video.
Ghana is like one of the safest places on this planet Earth. Especially, I think it's like rated number one, not of the world, but of Africa, is like the safest country. They have a great relationship with America and some of the other, you know, big time countries. And so they're a very peaceful country. Very, very nice people, very humble. And so there's not a lot of danger.
To Ghana.
Why Ghana?
Because like that's the only place I have like actual genuine peace.
Man. Okay.
You get me? It's like when you go to like Labadi Beach and then you're looking in the water, man. And then like you see there's this line at the end where it's like it separates the sky from the water.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like that's where God lives.
They're just so friendly and so kind and so sweet all the time. It takes a lot to make a Ghanaian mad. And even when they're mad, they're not rash. Like I said, they're not violent or anything, and it just passes and everything's going to be okay after that. So that's really sweet. They yell a lot, but they don't ever fight, and that's okay with them. Even their language is pretty aggressive. And so when I first got there, I remember thinking everyone was yelling at each other. And I remember asking my companion, like, why is everybody shouting at each other? And he's like, oh, they're not shouting. That's just the way they talk. I personally felt really safe all of the time, even after dark. Ghanaians are so nonviolent. They're the only only West African country who hasn't had civil war since they've gained independence.
You know, Ghana's my second home.
Yeah, I know, but I want to know which.
Shut up, house in Ghana.
Whereabouts?
I'm not telling you. I don't need to tell you.
So I want to visit.
No, I don't trust you. Go to Ghana. My friend's wife, she makes this crazy Ghana jollof.
Wow.
With some goat meat. It's bad. So, I love Ghana jollof.
So, they're just super friendly people. Super friendly. Like, one of the things I found out very quickly at the beginning of my mission is it's actually an insult to not say hello to somebody, which is way different than American culture where we just ignore each other walking down the road. They'd look at me and they'd just be like, you didn't say hi to me. I'd be like, oh, hi. They'd be like, oh, thank you. What's your name? And then they'd just introduce themselves. They're just a very friendly people that just wants to be around people.
Respect people. So I've just arrived in the airport in Accra, in Ghana, one of the most progressive African countries. And a lot of people wouldn't think that this is an airport in Africa, but it is. You should come and visit. And this is the entrance to a beautiful experience. Ghana has not very much violence. It has amazing fruits and foods. It has amazing sights to see. There's many, many beautiful people. The nightlife here is amazing. And if you are thinking about coming to Africa and you need a first experience country, this country should be the first experience country. It's beautiful. I don't know what else to say. I'm just happy to be here. Shout out to all of the people from Ghana. Shout out to all of the Pan-Africans. Shout out to all the people who are going to travel here. Come and buy land, raise your families here, move here, and get out of the West, because I'm hearing it's cold there. Mad thing.
So you see how people are, these are people who have come into the country and they have experienced the country. So sometimes, when you are talking about the continent, please come here, experience the place really well before. It's not when someone just steals someone's phone on certain petty things and you'll be like, when you come to Africa, just look at the police, how they treat you, the foreigners, or even the citizenry. You are not being racially abused, nothing. You are free to leave, to go anywhere at any time. So I just don't understand why black people, we are doing this to ourselves. We should put a stop to it, honestly. It's sad. It's sad. This is where I'm going to end the video. If you have anything to say, put it in the comment section. Comment and we are going to discuss about this or talk about this. Thank you so much for watching.